Tutor Outline, Melissa Maribel here. How can I help you?
Hi, Melissa. My name is Anna Karen, and my question is question number 12, which says, how many moles are in a 5.35 times 10 to the 22nd power molecule sample of Na2SO4? I've already started to work out this problem, but I'm not sure if it's correct, and any advice and help would be appreciated.
Okay, so let's work on this question together and just figure out exactly what to do. My advice on any tips or tricks I have to always get these questions right, especially for stoichiometry. So let's start that. For any word problem that you see, always identify what you're given and what you're finding. So that's step one. We will literally just see what is this question giving us to start with, and then what are we finding overall? So what this question is saying is we are given how many molecules the sample has. So that's what we're given with, or that's what we're starting with. And then we're asked to find the amount of moles overall in this compound. So we know that we're going from molecules to moles of the same exact compound. That is extremely important to see. One, are we changing the compound? Are we keeping it the same? Because that helps us figure out how many steps this question will take. So the next step is to pretty much just identify what we have to go to next. So are we going, like, how many conversion factors we're going to need? That's the next step. And let's go over just the different types of conversion factors you will most likely see for a stoichiometry problem. All right, so for step two, we said that we're going to determine which conversion factor or factors we have to use. So the first common one is known as molar mass. What molar mass allows you to do is it allows you to go from grams to moles, or the opposite way, from moles to grams. Looking at this question, we're not given grams whatsoever, so there's no need to convert anything to grams. So this one is out. We're not using molar mass overall. Let's do another one. Let's see what other conversion factor we can possibly use. Our other type of conversion factor is when we're doing a mole-to-mole ratio. For this, we are only going from moles of one compound, and then we're changing the compound. So if we're changing the compound, we will use a mole-to-mole ratio. However, here, we said we're keeping the exact same compound, so nothing's changing. So once again, now mole-to-mole ratios, we're not using that. It's not needed whatsoever. So nope, that one, we're not using that either. What's the next one? So another conversion factor that's possible is going from moles to liters. This one, if you haven't learned it already, you're gonna learn it in a later section, but just know that we are able to go from moles to liters or liters to moles, and this question is not telling us anything about liters, so we're not using that at all. So okay, that one's out as well. And then the last one that we're going to see is the actual one we will be using. So, this is our other conversion factor, Avogadro's number. And then Avogadro's number, there's a lot to it. However, what I want you to focus on, because Avogadro's number has atoms, molecules, particles, formula units, and all of that, really what this is saying is if you see one of these units, either atoms, molecules, particles, or formula units, you will use Avogadro's number. So in this case, because of the word molecules, and that's what I was given, I know instantly that I have to use Avogadro's number. Plus, Avogadro's number allows you to go from molecules to moles, and vice versa. We could also go from moles to molecules. So that's how I know exactly to use this conversion factor, and this conversion factor only. And then just note, remember what Avogadro's number is. So Avogadro's number is that one mole is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd molecules. So now let's just set everything up and do the math. So our next step is to convert our units and check our amount of sig figs, because we always want to round to the correct amount of sig figs. So what I'm going to do is I always want to start off with whatever I'm given. All right, so whatever I'm given initially, and that was the molecules. We initially were given our molecules, so that's what I start with. And then what I'm going to end with is whatever I'm finding. So what I want to do right now is I'm only going to use one conversion factor, which was our Avogadro's number. We want to align the units so they can cancel, meaning our molecules will be on the bottom, and I'll show that here. So our molecules will be on the bottom because we want those to cancel. So if you don't know when to use the conversion factor, sometimes you're gonna see it's flipped, sometimes you're gonna see that you're multiplying or you're dividing. It's all dependent on the units. All right, so whatever we want to do, whenever we look at this, you always want to cancel out the units. So that's how I knew that to cancel out the molecules, that the Avogadro's number has to be on the bottom. And that's exactly what would happen here, is Avogadro's number would cancel out because our molecules will cancel out. And then we're going to be left with just our moles. So all we have to do is divide these two values and we'll get our final answer, which is, if you note, it's going to be rounded to 3 sig figs. The reason why it's rounded to 3 sig figs was because our initial value, which was given, only has 3 sig figs. If we notice here, 5.35, there we have 3 sig figs, right? There's 3 sig figs. And then here, we're also going to see our final answer has 1, 2, 3 sig figs. If you want to get your question answered just like Anna did, then make sure to check the description box. The link to submit your question is right there. And if you need tutoring or homework help, all of the information is in the description box. Now, I'll be here waiting to answer more questions, and I'll see you next time.